So let's go through them one by one. Finding a polynomial time algorithm for an NP-complete problem, yes, that would show that P equals NP, because the problem is NP-complete. So it means it's among the hardest to solve problems in NP. So polynomial time algorithm for this problem will solve any other NP-complete problem in polynomial time as well. Finding an algorithm that solves an NP-complete problem in polynomial time on average, now that's a very interesting one, because you might be inclined to think, well, if it solves an NP-complete problem in polynomial time on average, then probably that is sufficient. Well, it shows a lot of interesting things, but it doesn't show anything with respect to P being equal to NP or P not being equal to NP. Now, showing that the most efficient algorithm for clique requires exponential time, that would show that P does not equal NP. Because clique is contained in NP, so if it requires exponential time, it means that there's at least one problem, namely clique, that is contained in NP, but not in P. Of course, as nice as it would be to show this, of course, it would also be quite difficult to prove this, because you would have to show that, again, no matter what algorithm you come up with, it always requires exponential time. That would be extremely hard to do, because you would have to consider any algorithm, even algorithms that haven't been invented yet, so to say. Now, showing that vertex cover has an exponential number of potential solutions, that is similar to the example I pointed out to you in the beginning of this unit, namely that just having an exponential number of potential solutions does not mean that the problem is hard. It can mean that the problem is hard, but as you've seen in the case of shortest path, it's not necessarily so. Now, reducing clique to shortest path versus reducing shortest path to clique, then you have to remember again what reduction means. So if you reduce clique to shortest path, it means that solving the shortest path problem is also capable of solving the clique problem. And since shortest path is solvable in polynomial time, if you manage to reduce clique to shortest path, that would show that P equals NP. If, on the other hand, you manage to reduce shortest path to clique, that doesn't really have any implications, because all you've shown is that shortest path is an easier problem than clique, which is something we already know. Now, if you look at all these solutions, well, of course, it's a bit of a subjective selection here, but what you see that is showing that P equals NP in a way would be quite easy. All you have to do is find one single polynomial time algorithm for an NP-complete problem. Then you have immediately shown that P equals NP. On the other hand, if you want to show that P does not equal NP, then you have to put in a lot of work, because you have to consider any possible algorithm, no matter how complex, how intelligent, how sophisticated, and still somehow make the case that this algorithm is not able to solve a problem like clique in polynomial time.